Hey everyone, it's Akbar, developer advocate at Figma. This month has been a big one for variables, and I wanted to give a quick shout on some quality of life updates for dev mode that are all related to variables. Now, this might be your first time hearing about them, so I'll start with a quick overview. Variables allow us to name and define reusable values that exist in our design, and these can be colors, numbers, or even font properties. We can give those values a semantic name that can describe how and where they should be used, and this lets us make sure our designs are consistent and helps us avoid typos or random inconsistencies. This also means that if we need to change the value, it'll change in every place that uses it. Another key feature of variables is the ability to specify aliases and modes. Aliasing is the ability for a variable to reference another variable for its value. So we can have a primitive that refers to a specific raw value, and that can be easily used across our designs. This could be something like our color brand over here. But then we can also have a semantic value that provides something more meaningful for specific use cases. Our button background primary is a good example here, where it's aliasing our brand color. Modes are another feature that allow us to specify how our variables should change in different contexts. One example of this is being able to specify how our color should appear in light mode and dark mode. Another example of this might be wanting to have different spacing between a mobile and a desktop layout. And down here, you can see that the buttons and the frames inherit their colors based on the theme that's being applied. And this is an example of how modes allow us to define variables that update depending on their context. Now, developers are pretty familiar with this concept of reusable values. And in fact, you might have already heard of the concept of design tokens. Design tokens is a way for developers to represent reusable values related to design, and variables in dev mode align really closely to that concept. So this makes it easier for designers and developers to speak the same language and make collaboration easier. One example of this is the ability for variables to specify a code syntax. For any given variable, we can specify how it should appear in code for the web, Android, or iOS. And our improvements in dev mode make it easier for developers to get all the context they need from variables directly in the file. Let's take a look. Let's start off with one of our most heavily requested features. You can now see all of the variables that exist in a file in dev mode. To do this, I will deselect everything that I have in dev mode, and then I'll see on the inspect panel that there's a new option for variables. If I click on this, it'll open up the variables table. And over here, I can see all the different collections that exist in this file, how many variables are in each, and in those collections, I can see what the names of our variables are, as well as their values assigned in different modes. If I click on a variable, I can also see details about this. So our default background color, I can swap modes to see how the values change. And down here, I can see that the default background color is actually aliasing white 1000, and the raw value that that's associated with is this hex code. And I can see some of that code syntax that we were talking about earlier. Up next is the ability to see variable details while you're inspecting in a file. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump into my file. I have this button component selected. And if I scroll down, I'm gonna see this inspect layer properties. And I can see some code snippets that define the style of how this button is created. In the code snippets, we can see our variables. And if I click into it, I can see all the information that we saw in our variables tables about this specific variable. That includes the name, which library it's coming from. Over here, we can see it's coming from the community library, and if I click on it, it'll take me there. And I can see all that other information that we saw in our variables table, including collection, value, scope, and any code syntax that's assigned to this variable. I can do the same thing with our colors. And similarly, we can swap modes to see how those values might change. And finally, we've also improved suggested variables. If a value is hard-coded in the design, Figma will try to suggest variables that they could be based on libraries being used in this file. Now, this feature isn't new, but in the past, we would suggest these variables by default and change them in these code snippets. And while that was helpful sometimes, it was a frustrating experience because sometimes our suggestion wasn't right and you wanted to see the original value. Now, instead, we see the hard-coded value in our code snippet, and we also see that Figma suggests a variable. And if I click on this, I can see where that variable is coming from and what the token is. And if I click on that, that token will be copied to my clipboard. We hope these quality of life improvements make it easier to get what you need in Figma. Make sure that you keep sending us feedback so we can keep improving. And we'd love to know what your favorite part of this release is. Thanks.